In this instruction video, it is shown how to use the Blimp device. The Blimp is a CTO scoring balloon catheter, the smallest on the market, and the guide wire is only going through the distal tip section as shown in the picture. Take the device out of the hoop, but do this carefully, because even though the device is very strong and highly pushable, the distal section is quite fragile because of the short monorail section. So handle the Blimp with care. Like any other balloon, remove the potential air by applying negative pressure with an indeflator. The balloon is very small, so it's hard to see any deflation. Activate the hydrophilic coating by wetting the device inside a saline bath. The Blimp can be inserted with the tip over the guide wire. The tip is a very short monorail section. It's a rapid exchange device, so the guide wire is exiting immediately from the proximal section of the tip. In the zoomed image, you can see how the device and the guide wire should look like with respect to each other. It is important to keep the Blimp device and the guide wire parallel to each other during insertion, and later on we will also show that this is important for the crossing of the device. In this example, we will show you how the device should not be inserted. So if the device is not parallel to the guide wire, there is a high risk of kinking the device. Of course, the device is not functioning like it should anymore in that case. So be careful while inserting the Blimp device over the guide wire. The Blimp can be advanced by pushing it over the guide wire. Due to the design, it is not possible to rotate the device. Again, it is important to keep the Blimp and the guide wire parallel to each other to improve the crossability of the device. The Blimp can cross on the heartbeat by bringing it to the lesion and holding forward tension on the device. And it's important to be patient, wait up to 15 or even 30 seconds, and by the movements of the heartbeat, the penetration forces will be transferred all the way towards the distal tip, which will result in crossing of the lesion. The Blimp is a CTO scoring balloon catheter, so it can be inflated in order to improve the crossability of the device. The nominal pressure is 25 atmospheres, and the rated burst pressure is 30 atmospheres, which the Blimp can easily withstand. These high pressures and the guide wire next to it as a scoring element will create high peak principal stresses, which may crack calcified plaque. Those forces can be up to 4 times higher than a regular balloon catheter without any scoring element. It is important to note that the Blimp crosses in small steps, so the device should be advanced just a few millimeters. If it is not crossing anymore, it can be inflated, deflated again. The cracks will create more space so the device can advance a few more millimeters. Again, the device can be inflated, cracks will be created inside the calcified plaque by the high principal stresses. It can be deflated, and there will be more room for the device to cross a few more millimeters. Once the device has crossed the lesion and has created enough space for other devices to cross, it can be retracted. This should be done with care and slowly. So it is important to keep again the guide wire and the Blimp parallel with respect to each other in order to avoid kinking either one of them. If the guide wire is getting entangled with the Blimp, it is important to also retract the guide wire. Sometimes it will help to just do this a few millimeters, so the guide wire and the Blimp are parallel again. These images show comparisons of the Blimp versus other CTO balloon catheters. For more information, visit imds.nl.